or long fins for snorkeling? Which is best? So what is a short and a long fin anyways? Typically, a short fin is under 25 inches, and these are mostly designed for snorkeling and swim training. A long fin is over 25 inches, and these are mostly designed for scuba diving. The very long fins you may have seen that are over 40 inches long are used near exclusively by freedivers and spearfishers. So what are the differences between short and long fins? Besides the length, of course. The key difference between short and long fins is thrust. Longer fins generate more thrust and therefore more speed. However, moving more water with each kick also means you need more power from your legs. If your kick is weak or your kicking technique is incorrect, then you won't get the benefits of the long fin's thrust efficiency. Short and long fins also differ in their maneuverability, how easy it is to turn and change direction with them. Because long fins produce a lot of thrust, even small kicks have the potential to create a lot of forward movement. That means to move finely and precisely with long fins takes a lot of practice using a variety of techniques beyond the simple flutter kick. New snorkelers and divers, however, will find it much easier to maneuver in short fins. The length of a fin will also impact its stiffness or flexibility. Both long and short fins can have varying degrees of stiffness, but generally speaking, long fins are stiffer than short fins. This is so they can handle the greater resistance they experience from pushing against larger amounts of water. A stiffer blade can handle that resistance without bending over much. However, the same stiffness on a short blade would be inefficient. Conversely, the ideal flexibility for a short blade would make a long blade too floppy to be effective. For snorkelers, short fins are a better choice for several reasons. 1. Less muscle fatigue. The main reason shorter fins are better for snorkeling is that they're easier on your leg muscles. You don't need as much power with each stroke, and each stroke will be shorter relative to using longer fins. 2. Easy to practice with in a pool. Many casual snorkelers will be accustomed to a swimming flutter kick, which requires short and fast leg strokes. That means kicking with a short fin will feel more familiar, and thus easier to get used to. In fact, short fins are a great way to train your legs for the flutter kick and are routinely used by swimmers for this purpose. 3. Less likely to accidentally kick something. If you're not used to wearing a fin, thinking of your feet as taking up several times more space than they usually do is tricky. Beginners can be clumsy with their feet while learning to kick. Short fins are also easier to maneuver in. That means a short fin will decrease your chances of kicking coral, wildlife, or even your fellow snorkelers. 4. Easier to travel with. These days, traveling by air is much more of a hassle than it used to be. Many airlines now have increased restrictions on baggage size and weight. Short fins are much easier to travel with as a result. I hope this presentation has cleared up any confusion you may have had about the length of swim fins. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and hit the notification bell for more useful underwater adventure content, especially if you're new to snorkeling or diving.